such tales roll over. Great towns and cities, and treasures, hoards of gold and silver, and a new god.
Gita, I've come to say goodbye to you properly. I've been thinking about you, about when you were small. You were so lively, you could run as swiftly as the wind. You were like quicksilver. But then, before I knew it, you stopped running here and there and everywhere. And you became still. At 12 years old, you had the stillness and the calm of a fine woman. What children you would have produced. What joy that would have brought to all of us. Dear child, Gita, you are not gone because you are always in my heart. They say a man must love his sons more, but a man can be jealous of his sons, and his daughter can always be the light in his life.
Power is always dangerous. It attracts the worst and corrupts the best.
I never asked for power. Power is only given to those who are prepared to lower themselves to pick it up.
I made the boat that took you to fame. I made the boat that will take you to your heaven.
I always dream of you.
What does that mean?
That means you've given me your heart.
What am I to do now? I hate you for leaving me. It will be at least another day before I am put to death. You and your gods are wrong. You see, I guided my fate. I fashioned the course of my life and my death. Me. Not you, not the gods. Me. This was my idea. To come here to die.
You believe that, so it is true to you.
I don't believe in the god's existence. Man is the master of his own fate, not the god's. The god's a man's creation to give answers if they are too afraid to give themselves.
Forgive me for all of my faults, all of my failures. No regrets.
No regret. And yet, every regret. It's been a long journey.
Not in the saddle, but in the mind.
All our journeys are in the mind.
In my mind. I wish I never left her far.